Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. So we're thrilled to have all of you here at the Fireside Chat between Dr. K.M.V. Narayana Rao, a well-known industry leader here with us today, who's joined us from Aragen Life Sciences, who's the Associate Vice President and Head for Analytical Development. We also have Mr. Ankur Sharma, who's the Sales Director for Agilent in India. So he looks after the complete business for Indian market for Agilent Technologies. And so today we'll be talking about the theme of sustainability and how organizations like Agilent and Aragen, you know, would be partnering or would be talking about sustainability initiatives, you know, for today, for the present, as well as for the future. So welcome, Dr. Rao. Welcome, Ankur. Good to have you here.
Thank you, Lalit.
Thank you, Lalit.
So first of all, thank you for your time given to us today in this buzzing Friday afternoon. I know the second day of India Lab Expo, usually, you know, there is a lot more footfall, there's a lot more turnaround, people have, you know, gathered here. It's a great opportunity and platform for all of us to connect and interact and collaborate, maybe after many years, you know, maybe after decades. So thank you once again for your time. So let's dive right in. So I'll just quickly, you know, ask you a few questions related to sustainability. As you can see here today, sustainability is our theme, and that's what we are trying to implement in Agilent as an organization. And I'm sure even Agilent, Aragen as an organization is implementing a lot of sustainability initiatives. In fact, recently I was just going through the ESG report, which Aragen has released, not from the quality side, from the R&D side, from, you know, all the departments. I think sustainability is becoming a real buzzword and a catchphrase for all of us.
Yeah.
So accelerating science sustainability, achieving sustainability and ESG goals for the present and future. That's the theme and the topic for the day. Ankur, let's start with you. How is Agilent approaching sustainability initiatives from an instrument manufacturer's perspective?
So first of all, thanks, Lalit, for, you know, wonderful, you know, conversation. I think this is a very, very important subject if I look at. And sustainability, if I look at from the Agilent perspective, I think this has been ingrained as a part of our value chain. I see that, you know, Agilent is constantly putting a lot of efforts in terms of, you know, sustainability. And we are taking right steps because, you know, I think the whole motive of Agilent as an organization is to, you know, help the mankind. And it's not only by providing the solutions as well. You know, we are also looking at that, how we can make our products and solutions much more, you know, sustainable and ensure that, you know, it is on a working for a greener planet. So I think it's largely what Agilent is always striving for, to do best for the society.
That's impressive, Ankur. Could you share some specific examples of Agilent's instruments or Agilent solutions that are meeting today's sustainability goals through, you know, I see this ACT or ACT label that I hear, and, you know, we see the ACT labels around all the instruments. So could you throw some light on that?
Yeah, obviously, I think this is a great way to start. And, you know, if you look at all our instruments, basically that is having the ACT label, which is already there. And I see that, you know, this ACT label has already been kept over here. So as we partnered with My Green Lab, that will also give, you know, a lot of confidence for our customers, because it is like, you know, what you have, you would like to demonstrate it to people. And, you know, these stringent guidelines, which has been given by the certification bodies, when it is shown in practical, like, you know, how we are following those steps, that builds a lot of confidence. And then, you know, it also helps customers to really for such solutions. And I see that, you know, whatever the systems we have put it on display, we are talking about the technology, but I think we are also showcasing that how these are environmental friendly systems.
That's right, Ankur. I mean, thank you for these insights. And for those of you here, please take some time to have a look at some of our solutions and instruments that are on display, which have these ACT or ACT labels from My Green Lab, like what Ankur was mentioning. Thanks again, Ankur. Now let's turn to Dr. Rao. How does analytical R&D, you know, where you come from, in the pharma industry, how is it contributing to the sustainability initiatives or goals? Or are you looking at that currently?
Yes. Thanks, Ankur. Again, I echo Ankur. And thanks, Lalit, for giving this opportunity to me, and then catching out with me, and then arranging this chat and fireside discussions.
Okay, sir,
and on the Analytical side, yes, I take it the two ways. Like on the analytical side, how we are implementing these sustainability initiatives, and as well as a whole in Aragen, we have taken this sustainability not only is a it is like an initiative type of thing, no, but it is a business driver.
Right.
And it is a responsibility to our organization. We took it in that way. And then if you see, we have published these ESG initiatives in our website, etc. So on the analytical side, you know that in the laboratory, particularly if you see, reduce the waste, that is one of the key area. And then use the green solvents.
Right.
That is another point. And reduce, we also take care of the environment, right? And then we take care of the, we reduce the, whatever the inhalation or the solvents which are evaporating, getting evaporated in the lab and all that we are reducing. And then use the lesser methods, like analytical method. If you see, instead of 40 minutes, 50 minutes runtime, we can reduce. And we use your high pressure systems also,
right.
600 bar, 800 bar instruments now.
Right.
And we use that, your Agilent machines, thanks for that also. So that also is contributing to the sustainability. That means lesser solvents and then mobile phase consumption and lesser time utilization and faster analysis as well.
No, I really appreciate, you know, like what Dr. K.M.V. is saying, because I see as an organization, Aragen is very forward looking and, you know, there are many good practices which I see from the sustainability part, but and other things which, you know, the as your organization is looking at. And I think I see that, you know, a lot of values merge, you know, and we see shared values with your organization. Thank you. You know, you are really taking those things in the right direction.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks, Dr. Rao. I think that's a fascinating perspective from the analytical R&D side. Of course, we will delve deep into that. And thank you, Ankur, for sharing your thoughts on this. I mean, it's inspiring to see both Agilent and Aragen leading the way towards a sustainable future. Now, let's talk about the broader industry perspective. How can pharma companies and OEMs like Agilent work together to ensure a responsible and sustainably greener planet? Ankur, I mean, we interact with pharma, the industry, on a day-to-day basis. Are we now starting to have conversations now with the industry about how Agilent can partner with them on driving both their sustainability measures as well as how Agilent overall is contributing towards it? Your thoughts on
that? No, I think it's a very good question. And what I see is that it's evolving. You know, this this particular thing is has really, you know, I see that the conversations are really picking up. Whenever we meet the customers, you know, it is all about this particular topic is coming more prominent. I see that right now. How we can collaborate? I think it will be good that we collaborate and, you know, we discuss all those things. And if I feebly remember, even in our office also, we have done a couple of events and, you know, the awareness programs, especially on the sustainability and environmental conscious. And we invited the right set of teams from the various pharma companies. I think it's more about, you know, keep talking about it and, you know, collaborating, education. I think as we are also demonstrating it over here in our booth, we shall be able to, you know, put it in our webinars.
Absolutely.
And seminars. And I think if you look at on our website, I think this is coming more and more prominent. And I'm really happy to see that, you know, these conversations are really becoming more important, you know, apart from the technical discussions, what used to happen earlier.
That's right, Ankur. I mean, do you have some specific numbers, you know, when you talk about Agilent as an organization, any particular figure that we are looking at? You know, we also released our latest ESG report. You know, as an organization, what is the target that we are looking at in the next, you know, 2 or 3 years? Do you have any?
Yeah, I think if I recollect, you know, some of the reports, like we have reduced, I think, carbon emission impact by around 37-38%.
Oh, that's.
And I think the water, you know, usage reduction close to around 30%, something like that. So I think these are the initiatives which we thought it cannot be achieved in a single day. But I think the whole idea is that we are making significant progress towards that direction.
Yeah.
Right.
And it'll enable customers and industry to make greener choices.
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, that's indeed very valuable what Agilent as an organization is doing, and you know how we are supporting, starting from the production to packaging to shipping and supply chain, and even at the time of installation, you know, we are following some of these measures.
Maybe if I can just take a minute. So, Dr. K.M.V., do you think that is it something which is the organization's initiative, or you feel that, you know, there is some regulatory requirements also which is driving?
No, both sides. Even compliance side also, like the environmental and all also, that also we are actually in line. And if you see the ISO 14001, that is the certification body that we got it already. It got renewed even recently. So that means in both sides, it is an responsibility, social responsibility, and as well as the compliance.
Okay.
Okay.
That's a great illustration of a win-win aspect, right?
Yeah.
Both
I just wanted to understand that, how is it working on both the sides?
Yes.
Yeah, very important. Thank you so much for it.
I also, thank you, Ankur, and thank you, Dr. Rao. I also saw in your recent report, I don't remember the numbers, of course, but Aragen is also committed to renewable energy in across your facilities, and resulting in a certain number of reduction in overall carbon or energy consumption, carbon footprint.
Yes.
What are your thoughts on it? Is it now coming across, or is it being implemented in all your sites and all your plants, your location?
Yes, exactly. We have the R&D sites and manufacturing sites across the globe.
Okay.
So we have the manufacturing sites at US also.
Okay.
And then what we took is renewable energy implementation and all that.
Waste consumption.
22%. Now it is.
That's impressive, Dr. Rao.
That if you see in our ESG report, it was mentioned it is around same number. And even the green gas GHG, that
Quality
has.
Yeah.
So that also around 20-22% we are now, and we are reducing it further. And moreover, the science-based technology, SBT, we call it as. So the science-based technology, as you mentioned, how we contribute.
Yeah.
Like our scientists always be in mind with respect to this sustainability, like reducing the number of steps.
Correct.
Say. That is most important.
Yeah.
And at the same time, using the green solvents in the solvent in the bulk itself, so that we can contribute to the all the this thing, and the sustainability will be improved.
I'm really happy to see that, you know, we are having this conversation, because because most of the times we talk more about the technical aspects, the applications.
Exactly.
I think these are the things which we have never touched base upon. Good that, you know, we are having this particular platform, and we are talking something, you know, which is for the planet.
I see that while interacting with your Agilent team, so you are going to implement the process testing in sampler.
Right.
Okay, I interacted with your global team earlier.
Oh, okay.
And then that will reduce the number of samples.
Yeah.
Per se.
Yeah.
If you see, I produce the around 16,000 samples per month.
Wow.
Oh.
And suppose out of 16,000, suppose if I collect 2 ml of the sample, I consume only 20 microliter. Okay, and the rest is going to waste.
Yeah.
So, but if you are going to introduce that in-process sampling and all,
it's going to be a game changer, I feel.
One game changer, and then there is no sample required.
Absolutely.
It directly goes into your HPLC, and then analysis is over.
True.
So it is a good initiative, and then you are going to, that's the good thing that we can see.
I mean, it's great, Ankur, that, you know, Dr. Rao is, you know, from his experience, you know, getting into the micro level details of, you know, from the lab as to how the analytical lab, I mean, that's where it all starts, right? And how from there, you know, once you scale it up, or once you transition into other divisions, It becomes all the more important for an AR&D or a QC to implement these measures immediately.
I think I look these as, you know, smaller steps towards a much larger goal, which is really commendable that, you know, we are actually heading into the right space here.
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, even our ICP OES, which is, like, if I can just share an example, which is on display here, that is also, if I'm not wrong, has reduced 15%. Less energy in the manufacturing. I mean, it's a new instrument that we have here today. So I think even we, from an organization point of view, I think, Ankur, you can add to this. Every new product development that we are coming up with, or in every new NPI or a new product introduction, as we call it, has a lot of these thoughts put in as mandate you know, when we start manufacturing or at the time of production. Do you want to add something to that?
Yeah, I agree with you 100% that, you know, these are the things, because innovation is one part of it. And we wanted to give the best of the technology to our customers, because the regulatory requirements are changing. You know, the application requirements are changing. We are getting into the much more complex things. Whereas, you know, we are also not overlooking the requirement in terms of, you know, the how we can help the carbon reduction or probably the water wastage, yeah. You know, those things. And I see that even each and every system, there has been a significant reduction in terms of, you know, these things, which is definitely going to make a lot of difference, I'm sure. And, you know, ensuring that, you know, energy is cost, right? So we are also ensuring that we cater to that requirement as well.
Oh, well. Yeah.
It's great to see innovation driving sustainability, Ankur. And it's great that, you know, we took up the example of what we have right in front of us.
Yeah, and I think for that matter, not only ICP-OES, but even HPLC, you know, LCMS and LCMS also have those labels. And I was really pleased to see that, you know, we are driving on various other metrics, which are very, very stringent, right?
Yeah. And coming to innovation, I mean, we are in Hyderabad, which is the hub of innovation today, one of the fastest growing cities, not just in India, but Southeast Asia or even the world. And how do you think the local government is looking at it? You know, if I'm a lab today and if I want to set up a new startup or if I want to set up a lab, how do you think the government is looking at this? You know, are they giving or are they providing any incentives for new labs or analytical labs which have or which would procure sustainability-ready instruments or instruments which have lesser carbon footprint?
Yeah, I think largely if I look at, you know, the governments are also working for, you know, the global platforms, you know, the commitments which are there for the climate change, etc. And I think the central government and I see even the state government is having those mandates. And I see that not only from the laboratory perspective, but even Telangana government has made a lot of investments in making this city green, right? So that's the thought process. And coming to the commercial side, I think there is a lot of incentive schemes, plus the tax benefits, which are also passed on to the people, you know, who are setting up the labs, the R&D facilities, just to encourage that, you know, that there is some conscious effort in that direction so that, you know, people are looking at those things. And when I interact with various customers, I see that there is a definite effort, conscious effort in terms of the pollution control boards also ensuring that, you know, the right set of certifications and the compliance they go through. So I think there is a all-out effort from the government per se as such.
Yeah. And I think Aragen and both Agilent, we are setting a very good example for newer labs, newer startups, and even for existing startups who want to expand on these sustainability measures.
Yeah.
Now coming to you, Dr. Rao, sorry to keep you hold for a couple of minutes there. Is Aragen having any one particular initiative that you are really excited about? Any upcoming initiative on a greener?
Connect to your point, like the water recycling, right? So we are planning to recycle the 100% that we are already in the some of the even facilities. We have huge facilities across India and then US. But some of the facilities we already took over.
That's good.
That the water recycling. And okay. That means waste and water. These two things which are most important.
Yeah.
We have to reduce the usage and reduce the wastage.
Okay.
Both sides. And then that we took the initiative and then we have already implemented and we set a decent targets for the coming years as well.
That's impressive, Dr. Rao. I think we really look forward to Aragen, you know, coming up big in, you know, in setting up these or coming up with these initiatives again to set bigger examples, you know, to the not just to the region as such, but to the whole country.
And somewhere I see that shared values are there with the both organizations, right?
Yeah. And Ankur, so coming to now consumer awareness, now companies like us or even corporations like us or Aragen, you know, we talk about this or we have started talking about this, right? Which is a great thing. How do you see consumer awareness about this? So how does Agilent plan to educate consumers or customers about, you know, these things on a day-to-day basis? Do we have some training programs or are we incorporating this in our events, webinars.
Yeah, I think we started incorporating it as part of some of the initiatives which we are driving locally as well as, you know, at a country level, and specific seminars. But I see that, you know, the sustainability theme, we kept it even in the previous Anacon also, and we are continuing with that. We had some of the small takeaways, which was also emphasizing more towards the greener planet and the sustainability.
Right.
But yeah, I think it's evolving, as I said earlier. I'm sure that, you know, this thing will start growing much more.
Right.
With each person talking and, you know, spending more time and explaining these things. As I hear Dr. K.M.V., you know, this is what I was saying, that we have been discussing on various other business matrices, but this is the first time we are also emphasizing and maybe looking at that other aspect of it.
Exactly.
This could be an inspiration to, you know, many of us here today. You know, if leaders like both of you come together, talk about this, I mean, that could be a great spark to something else,
yeah.
You know, something bigger. Coming to you, Dr. Rao, you're from the analytical development side. So we were talking about education and awareness and making people aware of sustainability and implementing these processes. From the drug development side of things, how do you see
that? Yeah, exactly. Thanks, Lalit, asking for that question. Actually, in our in the process of the development itself, because we are into NCEs development and all mostly, and then early phase, late phase molecules, and then scaling up to the next level. And then we start with milligram scale to the multi-ton scales. So our scientists always be in mind that, I'll take one example of recent one of the project. What we did is, actually, we developed the around 5 kilos scale. And then if I wanted to do the manufacturing of 50 kilo, I have to take 10 batches. And then it will take nearly 1 month time. But what our people did is, and then they brainstormed it and then took into the ESG also into consideration. And then they changed the entire process.
Yeah.
And then they are able to do it within 2 batches. That means 3-fold increase. And then reduced the runtime. The total manufacturing time is only 5 days.
Wow, this is great.
So that means 6 times it is reduced. That's what we think during the process development itself, so that it not only reduces the time of the manufacture, but also the number of batches will reduce, and the number of the volume of the solvents that we...
Yeah, certainly.
Enormously will reduce.
Yeah.
That is one of the things. So we implement all these things in every of our project.
Yeah.
Then that would contribute to the even society.
So somewhere, you know, you are trying to link all those things, you know, values also within the part of the process.
Yeah, that's really... Yes.
Yeah, I think that's a comprehensive strategy to stay in sync, both from the lab to, you know, to a corporate level, to a site quality level. I think everybody should sync well in, because as an organization, there's only a single interest, which is interest towards the community or a planet. And I think it's great that you brought it up.
But how do you see this, you know, is this easy or maybe, you know, a little complex when you have to bring all these things with the...
No, actually, we should be aware. We should be aware of all these ESG requirements, and as well as the culture itself here in Aragen particularly. We imbibe that culture.
Yeah.
So that means the people while talking, and then we say it's concept to commercial.
Yeah.
So we say that concept to commercial itself. So every stage,
yeah,
we think of this, and then implementation is, yes, there are so many other technologies that we can bring in. And then we can think of all those things and then use that, and then we can move forward.
But it's good to see that, you know, you are bringing that awareness at a scientist level,
yeah,
to the users, you know, this is on the bench also. Yeah,
exactly.
But do you see any, did you face any challenges by doing that? Or probably, you know, it is a time, effort, a lot of commitment also.
Lot of commitment from the employees and from the management,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah.
So, but...
How do you see the buying?
Yeah, the lot of interest now, the upcoming generations are also, they know.
Yeah.
They are aware. And then our ESG initiatives are also, they know. And then if you see everywhere, these reduce waste,
yeah,
and reuse, recycle, all these concepts are coming up,
yeah,
and then that being implemented in science.
Yeah. Yeah. That's wonderful to hear, Dr. Rao. It's been a pleasure here for this, you know, small interaction that we had. Any final thoughts, anything that you want to share where, you know, we can request both of us, you know, how to collaborate further, how to go forward, you know, driving the initiatives forward. If there is any room to, you know, come together, collaborate, and maybe talk to the industry about this and educate as well. So is there any final thoughts from both of you before we go to the audience for any Q&A? Any final comments?
Yeah, I think it will be good to see, you know, more partnership and the collaboration which will happen between the organizations. And
exactly.
We can definitely learn from each other what practices you are doing, how we can do it, and look forward that, you know, this interaction and this kind of thing which we have initiated, we should, you know, move further now.
Yeah, exactly. Not only in the analytical laboratory particularly.
Yeah.
Therefore, we see the more collaboration from Agilent as well, like how to reduce, reuse, recycle, and then how to increase my throughput.
Yeah.
And then how to reduce my run times using the different technologies and all these stuff. So this will help us not only to excellent,
right,
but also the ESG initiative.
Absolutely, Dr. Yeah. Thank you so much.